All right, I tweet that you put out there the other day, and I had already heard about this, but I was never going to tweet about it because, no thank you, but I'm going to let you talk about this more so, and I'll just chime in.
So good.
Alyssa Milano.
Mm. Oh, boy. Wow.
Who,
she's fighting the fight, let me tell you.
She always fights the fight, and she's a very strong voice out in the community in general. There was an atrocious, and we don't really get political too much on this show, but I'm going to give you my state on it, and I already saw from the dislike ratio in this video alone, and although it's probably more the Game of Thrones than
probably.
I think it was a very stupid and irresponsible bill that Georgia let go through, and it very, very. And you talk about what Rocha just said before, as far as men who don't get it. That's what happened in Georgia. But Alyssa Milano then called for a
hashtag sex strike,
right? Which, as much as I like what she's doing, I think this is ridiculous. Am I wrong?
No, I think you're completely right. I mean, I agree with you on both counts.
Just get married and have kids. It's a sex strike.
I think that regardless of what Georgia's doing, regardless of what you feel on that situation, which I feel the same way that you do, and I think it's horrible. But why this is the way to combat that, I'm missing something.
And who's going
to
do that?
So because I don't want to be told to what to do with my body, I should let Alyssa Milano tell me what I should do with my body?
Mm, right.
I'm confused. Why? What? What? Yeah. In what are you thinking?
Right.
And also, this has been the age-old thing of, like, if you don't want to get pregnant, then you shouldn't have sex. This is exactly what people want. Fine, if you don't want to get pregnant, right, you shouldn't have sex.
You don't want to get fat, don't eat pizza. Sorry, I'm eating pizza.
But it's like, my mind is so blown, because we talk about it on the show. I love when you're fighting the good fight, but you're fighting it the wrong way, sister. Like, right. What do you actually think that was going to do? Did you think all women out there were going to be like, yeah.
Right. And is she dating anyone right now? Is she married?
She's married.
Kids.
Exactly. It's easier for her to say, because I'm telling you, I'm there.
If she's even following it, which I'm not saying that she's a hypocrite, so maybe she is, but like, so you not having sex with your husband is going to make it so that
I'm on it.
In Georgia, women have the right to choose. I mean, what are you actually thinking is going to happen?
I love when he types in Alyssa Milano's phone number. So good. Okay.
I don't know. It's entitled white feminism. It really is.
I don't know, but you throw in the white thing a lot. I don't know if you need to do
not
that.
Not a lot.
You did it with Vince. I think you could have said old man,
well,
the same
Vince,
thing.
No, because Vince, that's why we, look, well, we Vince finally got a black champion in 2019.
Yeah, I think that one's a little bit more
Vince
accurate,
is more
though.
Relevant because he was talking
that
about
one's
race
more,
specifically.
That one's more accurate.
I don't believe that Alyssa Milano is white.
No, she is. She's Italian.
Isn't she half Italian?
She's full Italian.
But you get the sense, and you hear this from a number of this is happening within the feminism movement, this idea of white feminism versus actual whole feminism for all colors. And so this is that kind of thing. It's a little privilege to be like, sex strike, Lysistrata, all this stuff. And it's like, no, it's ridiculous, because I think Roxy's absolutely 100% right. If you don't want a man to tell you what to do, why is it okay if a woman tells you what to do with your body?
Right.
This is not going to cause change. Now, it may highlight attention to the subject, which I think is important. Like you said, it's an idiotic decision by this Kemp guy who barely won under suspicious circumstances his position there in Georgia to push this through. But this is starting to happen in numerous states now, this idea of pushing this idea through that you could go to jail for having an abortion, or you can go to jail for crossing state lines to go have an abortion. Or if you don't know you're pregnant until like 6 to 8 weeks or something like that, and then you do something and you miscarry the baby because you didn't know you're pregnant, you can go to jail for murder. That is the most ignorant, stupid shit I've ever heard in my life.
Right.
And don't hide behind God. Don't hide behind your religion. Most of the times, it's idiots who just want to control women and tell them what to fucking do. Mm. And it drives me nuts. And the fact that they miss you, because I'm a Christian, I believe in God, they misuse his words to promote their human tendencies, drives me out of my fucking mind. Yeah. And it makes me so angry.
I completely agree. And I think that Alyssa Milano feels the same way as you. And I don't understand how she gets from
that
to, aha, here's what we must do.
Right.
That's what it's that disconnect, because I agree. Mm-hmm. I agree. Mm-hmm. But then why are we on a sex strike? Because that's where I'm lost.
Yeah, it hurt. Again, fight was good, silly. But I want to talk about something way more controversial. Let's talk about Game of Thrones.
Honestly, it is it's more controversial. I'm not ridiculous.
It's ridiculous. There's way more things that are... It's ridiculous.
And you guys were right, by the way. She is fully Italian.
She's fully Italian.
Yeah.
I know that because I was obsessed with her when I was a kid. And,
oh, yeah.
And I'm half Italian. I thought, oh, look, we're going to wind up together and she can deny me sex when we get older.
Just checking in, by the way. How are you doing?